I'm worried today might be a little cheesy. Honestly, I'm hoping we could catch up sometime soon.
That thing was really good.
I love you very much. Krigma Corner. Girl, I want you to know. Woo! I can't get you out of my head, my head, my head. No. Girl, I want you to know. I don't even know what you need, you need, you need. Hello, SFY, and welcome back to Krigma Corner. You did it. Thank you guys for being here, for joining me again to... I'm so excited to share today's gospel with you guys. Let's dive in. What? Let's start by opening up the Word of God and reading today's gospel together. I invite everybody to just take a moment to recognize the loving presence of God with us here and now. To picture Jesus before you, and to let his word resonate in your heart. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. This is John 16, 20 through 23. Truly, truly, I say to you, you will weep and lament, but the world will rejoice. You will be sorrowful, but your sorrow will turn into joy. When a woman is in labor, she has pain because her hour has come. But when she is delivered of the child, she no longer remembers the anguish for joy that a child is born into the world. So you have sorrow now, but I will see you again and your hearts will rejoice. And no one will take your joy from you. In that day, you will ask nothing of me. Truly, truly, I say to you, if you ask anything of the Father, he will give it to you in my name. In today's gospel, Jesus makes a pretty bold promise. He tells his apostles that joy will come with his resurrection, that whatever they ask the Father in his name, they'll get, and that no one will take away their joy. We might hear that and think, no way. As Christians, we talk all the time about the joy and the peace that we are supposed to experience in a life with Christ, but oftentimes, I don't think we really believe that's what we're made for. I know I grew up believing that suffering was something to be sought out, that God would ask me to do things I didn't want to do, and that ultimately, he wanted my misery here on earth until heaven, not my happiness. Church leaders and youth ministers would speak to me about picking up my cross and following after Jesus, referencing passages of scripture taken out of context without an understanding of who they are as beloved. The joy of the gospel was a grin and bear it kind of life, but I don't think that's the life that Jesus was talking about in today's gospel. I don't think that's the life that Jesus was offering his apostles. We do not have to be afraid in a relationship with our Father that he desires our misery. We were not made to suffer. What we are assured and promised is that when we do suffer, Jesus Christ has already met us and conquered that suffering and is offering us resurrection. This is what he's talking about when he tells his apostles to pick up their cross and to follow after him. We are told in Hebrews that Jesus suffered so that we have a high priest who can sympathize with our weaknesses, one who's been tested in all things as we are, yet without sin. In a relationship with Jesus, we find a life of joy, genuine joy. Joy doesn't require or demand that we ignore our pain or our suffering or that of the world. In fact, joy requires that we accept just how bad things might be. By accepting the suffering, not passively ignoring it or offering it up, not trying to grin and bear it, or not giving up hope for our life here on earth, we actually allow the God who makes all things well to connect with us. If I am rooted, anchored in the reality that I am loved, taken care of, and sought after by the God who desires my good and the good of the world, there is always a remedy, always a response to my suffering. This is where we find the joy Jesus speaks of today. By allowing God the Father to connect with us in our suffering, we are able to encounter the little resurrections and new creation that He desires to bring about in our everyday life. If we are called to pick up a cross, brothers and sisters, it is because we are rooted in the resurrection that is promised to come. That is the joy of the gospel. That is the joy that Jesus speaks of today. Thank you guys so much for listening. I'm praying for each of you and hope that you're excited for this summer and all the things that we have coming. Please be on the lookout for more announcements. I love you guys. I'm praying for you. Rock on, SFY. Girl, I want you to know, I can't get you out.